Is the SA-58 still good in Escape from Tarkov, and how does the meta build looks like? This is the topic of today's video. Dear comrades, Ivan the German is back for you guys, and today we are taking a close look about the SA-58, a meta build for this awesome slappy juice cannon. And we are talking about, is the SA-58 still a meta weapon? Why is that so? So grab a beer or two, it's Saturday, you should enjoy your weekend. Let's start with the video. In my opinion, the SA-58 is still a meta weapon, but I have to admit I'm not good with the SA-58. I do not know why. For me, the recoil is quite hard to control. This gun kicks like a horse, and I'm basically not that good with the SA-58. But I would say if you enjoy playing the SA-58, this gun is great. I would say the SA-58 has the highest DPA in the game because you have the 700 rounds, fully automatic, 308 weapon, and you can shoot M68 with. So this gun can melt down your opponents quite easily. Let's talk about the build real quick. You have 66 ergo and 19 ergonomics. In my opinion, you need every recoil reduction you can get for the SA-68. So that's why we have 19 ergo. That's not that good. This one is a Barda, and you only need 4 Nyxo lenses. Unfortunately, it's a Barda level 4, but you need, as I said, 4 Nyxo lenses. So this Barda includes the hybrid suppressor. You need a lot of them for your gunsmith missions. And furthermore, you need the rail and the grip, so you will save some more rubles, and this meta build for the SA becomes a little bit cheaper. Let's talk about the build real quick, and I will do a pinned comment down below for every part you need. So first things first, do not suppress your SA-58. So what you have to do is to combine the BMD with the Lantec muzzle brake and the A3 adapter. This one is a great combination to reduce your recoil, but don't suppress your SA-58, you will lose a lot of good stats. Furthermore, you can change the RK2 grip to the shift grip. You will have 73 recoil, but 31 ergonomics. And you can also think about playing the RK1 grip, and it will have 70 recoil and 24 ergo. But the full ergo build is with the RK2 grip. Same for the stock, you can change it to the MOE stock, but you will also have 26 ergo and 70 vertical recoil. But in my opinion, recoil is quite important for the SA. That's why I'm playing it with the Gen 3 stock. Don't forget your tech light, and of course you can choose any side you want. Let's talk about the magazines real quick. You have the 20 round mags. In my opinion, I wouldn't play them, and I would recommend play 30 round mags. So, and for the 30 round mags, you have two options, the British 30 round and the Fall SA-58 30 round. So as you can see, the British are a bit better because you will only lose -8 and not -9 with the Fall max. You could play a 50 round mag, but you will lose -20 ergonomics. It's quite a lot. So what you should do is like play the British or the normal 30 round mag. In my opinion, that's the best choice. So let's talk about the ammunition real quick. Of course, you have three options, M80, M62 and M61. M61 is the best one over here. With M61 full auto in a close combat situation, the SA is just brutal. But M80 and M62 also is not that bad because you deal a lot of damage and your armor pen isn't that bad. It really depends on your budget, but M61, I use it almost all the time, is so brutal out of a 30 round SA-58 meta build. This is quite crazy. So let's check the recoil. First round, as always, no recoil control. So as you can see, we have this high initial recoil and this big muzzle flash with a little bit more recoil control. So as you can see, with the recoil control, you will have more rounds in the center of your target. Let's make a quick summary about the SA. I have a lot of problems with the SA because this muzzle flash, this brutal recoil in my opinion, and I don't know why, 66 recoil is not that much, but this optical recoil is very hard for me personally. I would say the SA-58 is a really good weapon in a close quarter situation. I know it's a 21 inch barrel version, pushing something on labs or dorms or whatever. This weapon is great. You will take down your opponents with a 30 round SA-58 meta build so fast. That's why, in my opinion, I think this is a good weapon, but I just can't play it that well as it deserves, in my opinion. So this video was a bit hard for me to find some good clips to show that the SA-58 is good. I tried it several times, but I really had problems with the muzzle flash and this like horse kicking recoil. I don't know why. As I said, 66 recoil is not that much. The AK-103 went by far better for me. I would say the optical recoil from the AK-103 is a bit better. I would say that a lot of you guys out there do not have the problems like I do. It's just a personal thing, but I wanted to show you that the SA-58 is still a brutal meta weapon in Tarkov right now. It is quite inexpensive. The basic weapon will cost you 40k and the parts will cost you around 100 to 150k. And of course you need the ammunition. You can craft M61 or you can use M80 or M62. It really depends what you like. So please guys, let me know what you think about the SA-58. Do you think it's still a meta weapon? On top of that, we have a Discord server right now. You're highly welcome to join us there. And in the end guys, show the world that we Germans can win at least something. And if it's your like, I would highly appreciate it if we can show that to the world out there. See you in the next video, guys. Bye.